Indiana author Kayleen Reusser has just completed her third book of military stories.
It's called We Gave Our Best, American World War II Veterans Tell Their Stories. She joins us this morning along with Rudy Woodkey. Rudy, thanks so much for your service and for coming in this morning.
You're welcome.
Let's talk first to you, Rudy. Tell us a little bit about your story. What branch of the military did you serve in?
I was in the U.S. Army Signal Corps and did stationed in outside of Reykjavik, Iceland for 23 months. We put up with the good weather in the summer and the nasty weather in the winter time. A lot of snow and cold. And I was in a base repair depot where we repaired telephones, radios, teletype for all the troops that were stationed in Iceland. And they were in, it was kind of a stepping off point for like the 5th Infantry Division before they got over to Europe for the invasion into Europe there at on D-Day and that. So
yeah, Iceland's one place that people don't really think of when they think of World War II.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and there was that build an air base there at Keflavik because at that time, in fact, that many years ago, airplanes couldn't fly all the way across the Atlantic nonstop.
Right.
So that was a refueling stop there in Keflavik, and that's it's a large commercial airport now. That's where all planes do land there today yet. But, yeah, there was quite a few. Well, we did all the bay repair for all of the troops stationed in Iceland up there and all.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Well, Kayleen, Rudy's story is just one of stories right. that you featured in your book. This is your third book now.
It is.
Talk about, you know, what it's been like talking to people like Rudy in writing these stories.
Every time I go into an interview, it's like a new adventure because I never know where in the world they really will take me, and I mean that literally. So there are 34 stories, as has been in my other books, and I have interviewed 250 World War II vets at this point. The new book has a couple of new advantages to it. I have a few veterans from outside of Indiana. My previous two books focused on the state of Indiana, but it's getting a little bit harder to find them now, so I'm going wherever I can find one.
Why do you want to share these stories?
Well, I started out by writing a newspaper column and interviewing veterans for that, and I felt like these stories were just living pieces of history, and we needed to preserve them so that our future children and you know, people, future Americans could understand what was done for them.
Is there a part of Rudy's story that was your favorite?
I admire him getting through the winters. That would have been tricky because it's a lot like Alaska, where it's nice in the summer and almost 24 hours sunlight, but the winters make up for a lot of that.
Oh, they do, yes.
For sure. Rudy, what's it like being featured in a book like this?
Well, I was really honored when Kayleen gave me a call and wanted to came to my house and interviewed me, and I, wow. I mean, that had never happened to me, and I hadn't ever given it a thought. And I really appreciated her, what she was doing. And I mean, keeping contact with all of these veterans and writing their stories and all, and keeping them alive.
Absolutely.
From back 70 years ago, 70-some plus years ago. So,
yeah, absolutely. Kayleen, future plans. I know you focus on World War II in this book. Do you have any future plans to continue with World War II or maybe move on to other veterans
well,
from other wars?
I have done 16 children's books as well for certain publishers, and I'm thinking about maybe trying to develop a series of World War II books for children.
Oh, very, very interesting.
Well, thank you both for being here. We really appreciate it. And again, thank you for your service.
You're
you can meet Kayleen and the veterans featured at her book signing on November 3rd. Catch this interview again on Wayne.com a little later today. There will also be a link to Kayleen's website where you can check out her books. We'll be right back.